Hey folks, good afternoon. 12:23 and across the valley, those temperatures already in the 90s. 96 for Rio Grande City, Edinburgh, 91 in Raymondville, and 94 for Wessego. Highs for today will be reaching 97 degrees as an average high. Cities like Rio Grande City and McAllen will be seeing higher temperatures between 103 and 99 degrees. Becoming sunny for today, breezy, and it will feel like 104. Winds coming in from the south-southeast, a bit windy and gusty in some areas, especially over at the coast. Now let's talk about those rain chances. For today, no need to carry an umbrella. Dry for our area as well as for Saturday. So if you have any plans for Saturday, no need to worry. But for Sunday, those rain chances will be coming back. We will have about a 20% for our valley. That's due to some sea breeze that will be pushing through. Then on Monday, we have more activity popping up. Tuesday, Wednesday, and Thursday, more rain could potentially be coming to our valley. Not all of that is due because we could potentially see a cold front move across our area. Now, we still are not sure if that cold front will be stalling just to the north of us, over us, or to the south of us. But here are the circumstances that could happen if this front stalls to the north, over us, or to the south of us. If this front stalls to the north of us, sea breeze and showers and storms could still be possible for our valley. But if this cold front starts to stall over us, we could see some isolated flooding and possibly a little more rain and activity over our area. Now that is due to all the disturbance that this mass of dry, cooler air will be clashing with the warmer and humid air, causing all of that instability to form potentially some thunderstorms and rain for our valley. Now, as this cold front, if it could potentially move to the south of us, it will be bringing cooler conditions. Now, it won't be bringing cooler conditions somewhere what you could expect in a regular cold front like 60s or 50s. No, nothing like that. Possibly in the 80s. So all of that is still too soon to know because the models right now are not agreeing, and it's still too soon to be able to get into a closer look into that. But let's talk about Texas. Current temperatures in the 90s over at the north. Amarillo at 93, 89 in San Antonio, 96 in Laredo, and 94 here in McAllen. Now, most of Texas will also be seeing a little bit of activity as that same front continues to push in for next week. So remember, that front is for next week, and we could potentially see some rain chances. All of it will depend on if that front will start to the north, over us, or to the south of us. So for this weekend, if you guys have any plans, we're seeing that for tomorrow, those temperatures will be reaching around 98 degrees, something very, very similar to today. Then remember, on Sunday night, we could potentially see some activity as well as in the afternoon. Remember that sea breeze could be kicking in, changing things up a little bit for us. Now, for those of you headed out to the island, this is what highs will be looking like for tomorrow. 89 degrees, Sunday 88. There could be a few rip currents in that area. For those of you headed out to the water today and tomorrow, here's a look at your coastal forecast. We still advise small craft to use caution, seas from 2 to 3 feet tall. And we're expecting for those temperatures in the 90s to still remain in our valley. But remember, right now, those temperatures are still iffy for next week, depending on where that cold front will be moving across our area. So remember, some rain and thunderstorms could be possible for next week, but you can always count on us to keep you updated. That was a look at your first Warn 5 AccuWeather forecast. Let's head on over to Dina and our friend Lizzie.